everyone, Heather Earls here. Thanks for coming on today's episode. This week, like every week, I'll be talking about natural living and healthy tips that will get you to rethink how you live and what products or habits you can easily change to better your life. So let's get started. Hey everyone, I hope you've had a great weekend. Today we're going to be talking about using time management and projects to release stress. We all need to reduce the amount of stress in our lives. With busy schedules and lifestyles, it's easy to build anxiety over everyday events. Stress, although not welcome, is present in every person on earth. However, we do have the ability to control our environment, which does help with stress, almost to the point of eliminating it. So what does your environment say about your stress level? Besides cleaning the house or working out, there are things you can create and do that will allow frustrations and negative energy to flow out. Craft projects and other things you enjoy are the perfect way to create an escape from a tough day. Enjoyable things could be building a breakfast bar, kitchen table, sliding barn door, or covering your wall in brick. On a smaller scale, you could create some mason jar magic. Refurbish old barn wood by sketching a picture or slapping some paint on it and see how your sign-making skills are. If you're more into pictures, then try scrapbooking. Love the idea of making your own curtains? Then join a sewing or quilting class. These are usually offered at a fabric store, or you can learn from a friend or family member. Music, exercise, learning a new language, these are all pleasurable ways of de-stressing. No matter your passion or interest, it's a good idea to take the time and refresh your mind, leaving the stress behind. Now, stress symptoms may be affecting your health, even though you might not realize it. You may think illness is to blame for that irritating headache, your frequent insomnia, or your decreased productivity at work. But stress may actually be the cause, common effects of stress. Indeed, stress symptoms can affect your body, your thoughts and feelings, and your behavior. Being able to recognize common stress symptoms can help you manage them. Stress that's left unchecked can contribute to many health problems, such as a high blood pressure, heart disease, obesity, and diabetes. That was from the Mayo Clinic. Now, given this information, don't you wish you could slow down time and enjoy everything? It is possible to take a step back and see what you could change to be more efficient, stay focused, and enjoy things you love like crafting and turning your house into its own masterpiece. Now, the bridge between the things you want to do and the reasons you're feeling stressed is that you only have so many hours in your day. Trying to get the most out of your day requires that you utilize some time management skills and techniques. Granted, there might be different strategies or techniques to use at different points in your life, but the concept is pretty much the same. Time management is a huge key no matter what stage you're at. If you can break your day into blocks of time, then it allows your mind to focus on what you are doing at the moment. That's the biggest reason we stress. There's always so much to be done and so little time. Some people will get so overwhelmed, they just sit and veg out instead of doing anything. Now, here's just a little example of what I'm talking about. Say the kids want to play, read, or do something with you, but you have other things you need to accomplish first. This might be fixing the refrigerator, starting lunch, or balancing the checkbook, but they don't understand and they keep asking. Your overwhelmed meter starts to hit that peak point before it explodes or deflates, leaving you feeling defeated, or you just don't want to do anything. People know when you're not focused on them. A child can see if you are distracted or crabby, as can a spouse or other family members. You need to give quality time to those you care about. So, how do we make time for ourselves and others while balancing what time we have? Well, I'm going to give you a scenario as to how this might look. Sweetheart, I would love to spend quality time with you, but I need to accomplish some things first. After that, you will have all of my attention. Okay, that's something you could say or do. If you're talking to kids and they are really young without any concept of time, you can make a clock out of a paper plate or purchase a clock from the store which has the hands, you know, they'll move, the short hand, the long hand. Now that you have the clock, set the time on theirs, Point to the time on the real one on the wall or wherever you have it, then say something like this. When these two hands match up, it will be your special time. This method can also be used with your spouse, minus the clock. That one might get you slapped. The idea is to make time, confirm it with whomever is involved, and then you are free to accomplish and focus on everything else that needs to be done or you want to spend time doing. Now, one very, very important rule: follow through and be on time. Building trust with those you care about is worth more than anything else on your day's schedule. You respect them, and in return, they respect you. Do not give that up by going 5 minutes over or saying, I'm almost done. That is not cool. Ask me how I know. I have tried it and it does not work. So get into a routine. Waking up at the same time each day allows you to make a schedule. If you are all over the place when you get out of bed or when you go to bed, how on earth are you supposed to get anything done? To keep track of your time each day, I've made a weekly time management schedule, and you can go to heathererls.com/time management, and or you can get one or purchase one on your own. This is a weekly chart you can download and print as many times as you like. And like I said, you of course have the option of making your own or using a daily planner. I like to use this particular one, like I said, so I can print it out. I can hang it wherever I want. I usually do it on the refrigerator where everyone can see it. Sometimes I print a second copy and keep it by my desk. That way I'm reminded when working that it's time to move on to the next thing. Also, my phone calls that come in, I can look at my schedule and see if I have slots open. Now, there are only so many hours in the day. If your schedule is full, don't be afraid to tell someone no. It's not harsh or unfeeling, it just means you have decided to stay focused on what you already have scheduled. People will understand and also respect you when you put your priorities in order. No one wants to die from being stressed out, and we all want some enjoyment. So take your time and manage it to your advantage and your family's. All right, so a little summary. You want to have a routine, schedule your time, build trust with those you have scheduled by keeping your word, be on time, don't be afraid to say no, and make time for crafts, projects, working out, or other things that you enjoy. If you follow these steps, I promise you will be more focused, less frustrated and stressed, you will not feel guilty, and everything that needs to be accomplished will be. And this sickness and illness is not included in this. Well, that's what I have for you guys. I'm wishing you the best. Have a great week, and we will talk to you next time. Thanks for listening to today's episode of Urban Wisdom and Natural Living. Tune in next week, where I'll broadcast live every Monday morning at 8 a.m. If you miss it live, hold those tears and head on over to my blog, which is heathererls.com. That's Heather, EARLES.com. There you can have 24/7 access or right here on iTunes. If you want to follow me on social media, you'll find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and Pinterest. Have a healthy week.